Hi, today we are going to cover one of the most important elements of a food business, and that is how to sell your food and how to sell it as if you're selling hot cakes in a bakery as fast as possible. One of the biggest challenges which I feel a restaurant owner or any kind of food business owner faces is getting more orders, getting more bulk business or getting more sales. And this is one of the biggest roadblocks which I find, which really disrupts everything else in the operations. If you don't have the right amount of sale coming in, if you don't have the right amount of money coming in your business, you cannot afford to hire good people, you cannot afford to pay your rent on time, your deposit on time, and everything starts going in the down spiral. That's why I have picked up this topic. This deep presentation is one of the most in-depth explanation of how you can structure your promotions in such a way that you can really promote your product in front of the needy people, sell them more, make more sales, make more profits, take home a lot of money, as well as take care of all your expenses and have a very, very financially independent lifestyle. Go through this training without any disturbance because I have covered it in depth. This training was actually delivered to my RLFCP members, my Restaurant Launch Formula Coaching Program members. And if you really want to know more about that, or if you want to go through my free workshop or my 5-day WhatsApp class, the link is given in the description section. Just join it and you will come to know about it. But more than that, if you are owning a food business or if you want to start a food business, mastering sales is one of the best things which you can do in order to be successful at it. Go through the training, enjoy, click the link below and join my live WhatsApp class or join my free workshop if the link is given in the description section. See you when I see you. Enjoy this training. Take care. Bye-bye. Cool. So how to sell your food like hotcakes? I know it is a very, very cheesy title, but the presentation which I have for you is going to really open your mind and give you a lot of things to think about when you think about promoting your business. So there are a lot of things which exist and a lot of activities which you have to do when you promote a business. But you know, if once we put everything under one specific goal and we then focus our energy and our attention towards it, then we are completely behind achieving something. Type yes in the chat box. Sometimes if you have gone to do something and you have got confused, you know, either I should do this, either I should do that. So today I wanted to give you a complete wholesome goal of what to do, complete wholesome roadmap of what to do in order to increase your sales, grow your brand, as well as grow your list or grow your customer base. Yeah. So with that said, let's start. So everybody, let me ask you a question, and I want everybody to answer that. Please tell me which business are you in? Let's say you're owning a food business, for those of you who have not yet opened. Or else for those of you who have opened a food business, what do you think you are in, which business? I want everybody to answer answer by chatting in this. Which business are you in? This is a very, very strong question. That's why I have kept it here. Chikki is saying, Chikki means, I think it is it Kavita ji or, I'm so sorry, I could not relate to the name. Yesterday, last week only I had Kavita ji, yeah. Kavita ji saying Chikki. Food, Nikhil is saying Chinese and fast food restaurant. Rizwan Sahir is saying building materials. Okay, since you are not in this business, that's fine. I am saying that imagine that you have opened a restaurant business. After that, after owning that restaurant or food business, what do you think in which kind of business you are in? Sachin is saying restaurant food business. Subhangi is saying home kitchen.
Ashwini is saying hotel only rooms. Okay. Sumit Harkare is saying manufacturing gears and okay. So all the people who are owning their businesses, let me open your eyes to this reality. Whatever businesses you are owning as of now, you are not in that business. You are only and only in the business of marketing your food business. Everything starts and ends with marketing. Type yes in the chat box if you agree to this. If you know, all of you are successful out here, all of you are running your restaurant, nothing is possible if you would have not put out the word, put out your video, put out your offer, put out your name, put out your voice, put out your expression, expressed your brand out. So everything starts and ends with marketing. And this should be 80% of your time, of your day, should be focused towards how to do what today I am going to tell you to do in order to make sure the pipeline of your orders keeps on getting full. The more you do this, the more you are going to get orders, the more you are going to get opportunities, you are going to get kind of like lucky shots where you get big orders also. But at the same time, you will get regular revenue coming to you. The only reason is you are keeping on doing that. Yeah. So you are always in the marketing of your business. Especially now, since you're owning a food business, you are in the marketing of your food business. You are not in the business of selling idli, selling vada, selling pizza, selling pasta, you are not in that business. You are only in the business of promoting that product, marketing that product. Type yes in the chat box if you agree to this. If you get this simple distinction, you will never starve or never go in losses, because that will take up maximum of your focus. This is the one thing, one domino, which if it falls down, all the other dominoes falls down. What I mean by dominoes is, this is the one thing, if you do the right way, it will take care of all the problems. Type yes in the chat box if you agree to this statement that sales is the solution to all your problems. Type yes in the chat box. Sales is the solution to all your problems, because the more sales you have, the more revenue you have, the more profit you have. The more profit you have, you can take home more money. The more profit you have, you can pay great salaries and hire good people, who can better quality people who can work for yourself and take good care of your customers. The more profits you have, you can reinvest it into your marketing and reach more number of people. The more money you have coming in, it will take care of all your, it is like oxygen. Basically, the more oxygen you have, the more fresher you feel. Yeah. So what is our goal today? Let's start going deep. So our goal is to sell the most and highest value products. The most and highest value products. Second is to grow your list. What I mean by list is to grow your network. And third is to grow your brand. By the way, I'm going to give this presentation to you, so you don't have to worry. I will post the link of this video as well as the link to this presentation, so you don't have to drastically take notes, but just focus on what I'm trying to tell you here. Sell the most and the highest value products. The most, the reason being, as many as possible and with as big profit margins as possible. Increase your awareness so that as many people know about you as possible. And third is growing your brand. Yeah. Is everybody following up till now? Type yes in the chat box. Great. I hope I'm not going too fast. Yeah. So now I'm going to go in depth and give you a plan. So these are the four things which you have to keep on focusing while increasing your sales. First is your story. So wherever you are available on YouTube. First of all, you have to be present everywhere. And I strongly suggest, for whatever reason it may be, just on your name, you create a YouTube channel, you create a Facebook business page, you create an Instagram account, so that you reach on its own. So your personal account is one thing, which existingly, if it is, that is not an issue, but create a separate business account for your business name or for your name of the brand of the food. The reason is, and you don't have to think, even if it is small now, slowly and eventually it will grow. So first is what you stand for. What is your mission? So if you know, I'll take my example. You guys know my mission. My mission is to create 1 million successful food business owners all across the world in coming 10 years. The same way, the people who land on your YouTube channel, on your Facebook page, who should first know something about you, whoever you are. Let's say, for example, Vijaya ji is here, or Kavita ji is here, or Parikshit is here, whoever. You have to start with, you have to tell them three things. First is, what is your name, where you are from, and why are you doing this? For example, I'll just come up with something for Vijaya ji. Hi, my name is Vijaya Ganbutte. I am from Pune, and I am a home chef, and I cook amazing Maharashtrian food. And it is my mission to help and to serve food to people who really crave for authentic food, and they don't like to go for commercial food. They like the authentic homely food. So something like that. You have to have three things. First is your name, where you are from, and what you stand for. So that is one thing. Second is about your food. So whenever you are cooking your food, you are presenting your food, make sure that it is visually available to see on these social media channels or on YouTube, Facebook, everywhere. See, because how much ever you have the menu in your mind and you have the idea in your mind, your prospect or your audience is not going to know that you are going to serve that. Isn't it true? Type yes in the chat box. So you have to create, you have to take, and you can literally use your mobile phone. You don't need to, you have a lot of filters. You can literally use your mobile phone. Let them know what your food looks like, how, you know, so a visually, when somebody looks at your food, it becomes more appealing. And, you know, it kind of becomes more wantable. Let's say, for example, it is 11 o'clock or 12 o'clock and I have missed my breakfast. And I see Vijayaji's post about her stew and something, appam and stew. And I like, oh my God, bhook lag gaya. Immediately I will call her or I will text her. Vijayaji, can you please order me one or two or three plates? So that is what food means to a person. We don't have to complicate it, but we have to keep on putting posts about our food. Your mission video can be a couple of videos, but your food, how much ever items you're coming up with, make sure that you remove the photos and you put it and you share it with your team. Third is your specialty. So let's say people love your food. You can always request them, sir, would you like to write me a review, or would you like to just shoot a video with you and everybody eating it, and just give me a little praise so that I can share it with all the other customers. Of course, everybody is not going to give you the testimonial, but you hardly require 3-4 testimonials. So let's see, for example, in my case, you guys have given me so many testimonials, which I use to show to the strangers what kind of a product I have and what kind of training I am giving here, so that they get inspired and they join it. Isn't it true? Type yes in the chat box. And now you can use these tools like Fiverr, Upwork, or Canva. These are all free tools which you can use. Fiverr and Upwork, you have to pay, but you can use these tools to get your posts designed, to get your videos designed. They hardly take $5, $10. You know, you can just shoot a video and you can send it to them and they will edit it and send it back to you. So nowadays, editing and designing has become so easy. You can use canva.com. It has got ready-made posts for you. You can create videos also on that. So this is a very, very powerful tool which you have to keep in mind. So this is your story. It is about you, your brand. Now we will go towards the food aspect of this business. Everybody following up till now? Are you guys loving this? Type love in the chat box. This is kind of like a holistic view of how you look at sales and how you think about increasing sales. Sales is not about discounts. Sales is not about shouting on the rooftop about your food. There is something strategic in it, which you, if you do, you know, subconsciously you enter in the mind of your prospect. And whenever the time comes when they want to buy something, your name will pop in and I'm going to show you, I'm going to prove you how you do that. Yeah. So before you even start selling, you have to think about this one concept, which I call as dynamic pricing. What I mean by dynamic pricing is you should have three levels of food products. First is the low level, kind of like a for the masses. Second is the medium, and third is the high level. So now you guys must be knowing about this. Now let me see how I can zoom this. Zoom in. Okay. So you guys can see this, right? My winning formula to W is you should have something to attract, something to magnetize, and something to profitize. So initially, if you are targeting some people about your product, and if they want to sample your product, you should have your best product available in a combo offer, which you can immediately send them, because you are already cooking it for other customers. And you know, they would love the taste, and they will give them an idea about an overall taste and experience about your brand. So this is the attracting factor. That doesn't mean you need to sell it cheap. You can sell it in whatever rates you have, but this will kind of attract the people. Secondly, you have to create certain products which will reach different target clientes. You can create platters, you can create combos, you can create bigger options also. And third is, for actual profitization of your products, you have to take bigger challenges and opportunities, like bulk orders, like events, like, because that is kind of like a bigger, because it goes into volume. So let's say you are having a restaurant and you take a wedding booking of 250 people and you outsource everything else, and you're taking up that challenge. Let's say you're charging 500, 600, 700, 800 rupees a person, and you're just taking up the catering order. That is kind of like a big surge of income and big surge of revenue in your business. But that will come when people have fallen in love with your brand and your food. Isn't it so? Type yes in the chat box if you agree to this. So you have to keep that in mind, because unless and until you don't take the bigger opportunities, you will not have bigger cash insertions in your business. And that cash insertions will be kind of like the ultimate payoff in your food businesses. So you need to have these three steps in your menu. One would be the basic, second would be for medium, and third would be for a little bit higher version. Yeah. Then third is perfect packaging. Use good packaging so that people. So if you're selling food, this is mostly advised for deliveries. When you're delivering food, make sure you use good packaging. So because your name is attached to that food, and if your packaging is messy, or if it spoils the food, or if it spoils the texture or everything, your name will get spoiled. It's not about that 100 rupees food which you have said. It is about the name, and people will. If the people don't order from you, you will lose the whole average lifetime value of a customer. So let's say a customer orders once every month from you, and ideally he orders for 500 rupees. For 10 years, that customer is worth at least 1 lakh rupees. So if you just mess up with this one packaging stuff, you will lose a customer who is worth lakh of rupees, because that guy is not going to order from you anytime because of the bad experience he has when he has ordered his food. Isn't it true? Type yes in the chat box if you agree to this. So use good packaging and focus on list building. Connect and collect. So what I mean by that is, always, this should be a regular activity for you. If you're on Facebook, if you're on WhatsApp, if you're on an email ID, if you're meeting somebody, make sure you connect to them through all your social media channels. Let's say, for example, you're meeting somebody on the street and he comes to know about you. Hi, where are you? What's your name? Where are you on Facebook? Send him a friend request. Because the more you connect with everybody and more you increase your network, somewhere down the line, he will not forget you. She will not forget you. And wherever he requires anything, he will come in contact with you, and you are going to sell something. So always have a focus on subscribers, friends, groups, and portals. Keep on joining different groups, different portals. By the way, these are all free. It will require only your time, but this has to be done continuously so that your overall network and connection keeps on increasing and you reach as many people as possible. Yeah, let's move ahead. So now I'm going to tell you the process. There are two ways how you can market yourself. One is organic, which is free, and second is paid marketing. So let's look at organic marketing. So by the way, the only focus of organic marketing is connecting with your customers, keep on sharing posts, and make sure that your post and your videos are shared by the people who are watching these videos. So if you remember, if you go on my YouTube channel, whenever I make a video, I always request people in the beginning of the video and in the end of the video to subscribe to this channel, to share that video, and to press the bell icon. Why do they do that? Because that creates a viral effect. Let's say one person is sharing it on its group and five people see it, they share it. So 1, 5, 25, 125, 500, 1,000 people. So it becomes kind of like a virality effect. So you have to, this is very serious. It's a conscious effort and you have to keep on doing it because that is going to help you. So if you remember a couple of months back, I had shown you this concept called as organic snowball effect. So a snowball basically in a icy kind of a place, when a very cold place where there is a lot of ice, when they have huge snowballs, which are rolling down, they always start small. You know, they're very small, small, small. Then they become big, 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 and they become so big, then they become destructive. So here is your snowball effect. First is a customer enters your sphere of influence. What you mean by a sphere of influence is he watches you on Facebook. He watches your YouTube channel. He watches your, so by the way, tell me, type me in the chat box if you have come in this RLF coaching program after watching my YouTube channel. Type me in the chat box. How many of you have come here by watching me on YouTube? So this is how you should re-engineer, or you should engineer the pathway for your customers. You should create these different free media portals, which are YouTube is free, Facebook is free, Instagram is free. Fortunately, we are living in the best times ever in this world, because everything which we need to promote ourselves is free. So you should create a YouTube channel, a Facebook page, Instagram, WhatsApp, LinkedIn, and let people enter your sphere of influence. If they see your post, if they see your video, if they see your information, first of all, if they like it, they will like and share. In fact, you can request them to do that. Third is, if once they like and share, they enter your fear of the other people, enter your fear of influence. They again like and share. So this virtuous circle keeps on increasing, and it becomes as big as possible. And you have a very, very strong following. This is a very, very simple rule, which all the top influencers have been following for such a long time, and they are minting billions of rupees. Yeah. So these are the three things which you have to keep on focusing. You know, if you always just keep on posting about your food, people will get bored. So you have to find out different ways in which you can reach them without sounding very salesy. Type yes in the chat box if you agree to this. Let's say, for example, if I always come each week on a mastermind session and I will tell you, "Arey, mera higher consulting program le lo. मेरा हायर कंसल्टिंग प्रोग्राम ले लो, मेरा प्राइवेट कंसल्टिंग प्रोग्राम ले लो, आई चार्ज 10,000 रुपीज अ मंथ, प्लीज कम इन माय हायर, यू विल गेट बोर्ड, यू विल नॉट अटेंड दिस मास्टरमाइंड सेशन, बिकॉज यू विल से अरे क्या यार, व्हाट इज दिस, एवरी टाइम गोपाल सर कम्स ऑनलाइन ही इज जस्ट यू नो ट्राइंग टू सेल अस. सो द बाइंग ऑफ माय प्राइवेट क्लाइंट प्रोग्राम और बाइंग ऑफ योर प्रोडक्ट शुड बी अ eventual decision for your customer, but you have to keep on sending them different posts, like nurturing posts or videos, something related to your food. Let's say, for example, you are serving Keralite food. If you find some information regarding Keralite food, you share it with them so that it can add value to their life by giving them more information about their food, and they will not forget you because they will obviously see who is sharing that. So inspirational posts, nurturing post, you know, type yes in the chat box if you agree that all we are seeing now on social media, on WhatsApp, is negative news. Everything which we are seeing now is negative news. We are not, you know, politics is happening, you know, rapes and unfortunate. This is all unfortunate, but we are consuming it as humans. So once in a while, if you share something inspirational, how much ever cheesy it sounds, but it really helps the other person to lift their spirits. And that is where he will never forget you. So make sure that you post something which is, if you are doing 3 posts in a day, nothing like it. Do one nurture post, which is related to about your food or something which related to your food. Secondly, inspirational posts or videos, which will boost their spirits and, soften their mood. And third is, you have to also put in sales posts. What I mean by sales posts is, let's say you are selling stew, Appam and Stew, a nice photo of Appam and Stew with your logo on top or your name on top and the price of the dish. Let's say it is 240 rupees per piece. Call this number now. So a post like that, maybe you create a video and you finally, you know, give the price. So this is a sales post, but in a very, very elegant way. So these 3 things have to be, you need to do it every time, because this will make sure that you are in front of your customer every day. And don't just think that, you know, your customer will get bored of you. He is getting a lot of posts. So you have to make sure that you are in the forefront of his attention so that he doesn't forget you. Remember, there is a saying in Marathi, Hajir to Vajir. If you are in front of that person, whenever he wants to buy something, he will think of you. Type yes in the chat box if you agree to this. What is a private client program? Sachin, get in touch with me on WhatsApp. I will let you know about that. In fact, Vijayji had also told me to connect, but unfortunately I couldn't. So keep on posting this. And this is free, but it will really, really help you to be in the forefront. And eventually you will see that your orders will start increasing. In fact, you will never know who is ordering. You will never come to know how a person has ordered, because you know this viral effect and the people who will share your post, somebody who is connected to somebody will get to know and he will call you and you might get an order. So you always have to be in their forefront. Now let's move towards the other thing, paid marketing. Now once you have started doing very well here, and if you really want to take your growth to the next level, then you can. So type me in the chat box if you have seen my ad on Facebook and you have joined this RLF coaching program. Type me in the chat box. I am betting a lot of you would have checked out. See, because what will happen is organic marketing, although it is free, it takes time, but the speed of organic marketing is limited. It is not scalable. So yeah, Parikshit ji, Parikshit, Kavita ji, Mukund, you all have seen my ad and you have joined me. So make sure that once you are making a certain amount, Ashwini ji has also joined me after seeing my ad. Once you get a certain amount of secured income and revenue in your business, you can take a certain percentage of it. Let's say, for example, you are doing 50,000 in a month. You can take 5,000 or 2,000 of it and you can start putting it in ads so that nearby people who are staying nearby your area are knowing about you. Because keep in mind that you need to fill your pipeline with orders as well as you need to fill your pipeline with fresh customers. Type yes in the chat box. Not every customer is going to be with you for lifetime. Of course, we hope that it will happen. But you know, sometimes people get bored. Sometimes people forget about you. Sometimes their taste change. Sometimes they themselves change, they go somewhere else. So you have to keep filling your pipeline with new customers. And the only way to do that is to reach them and tell them that you exist and such kind of food exists. So by the way, you can create trial kits, especially now. Let's say, for example, you want to attract bulk businesses with you. You can get hold of, you know, people who are big decision makers, like a chairman of the association or principal or somebody, and you can just get in touch with him, and with a good faith, you can just give them a trial of your food. Hi, sir. My name is Vijay Ganbote and I'm a home chef, and I would really love to introduce my food to you. And this is a kind gesture from my side. Please have this food from my side and do let me know if you have any feedback. So once you do that, what you're doing is you are actually creating a kind of like a favor to that person by feeding him. And whenever the opportunity comes, that guy will come back and he will call you. Hi, Vijay ji, I need 100 people's food. Please, can you do that? So this is one of the coolest tricks which I do in my resort and in my restaurant. All the companies which are there, I always call their heads, their general managers, their HRD managers to come and have food at my place. Or sometimes we sponsor the food at their company's place. And whenever, so now once they have that Kamath's name in their mind, whenever anything comes up, if they require rooms, they will choose Kamath Resort. If they require food, they will choose Kamath's Govinda restaurant. So you have to have in mind, this is, and fortunately, I mean, how much is it going to cost you? Let's say you are sponsoring food for a college, and if you want to grab hold of that college bulk business, let's say you are giving food for 5 people, food cost hardly will be 500 rupees, but the value of that customer and the power of that customer is pretty high. With one simple order, if you get a 200-300 packs breakfast pack order only, it will take care of all your cost, and in fact it will be far more profitable, and the relationship with your customer will be on a totally next level. You know, type love in the chat box if you love this idea. I have used this time to time to attract whales. So, you know, in gambling there is a term called whales. Whales means, you know, the bigger fish which are gambling more and which are spending more on gambling. The same way in our marketing and sales, we look at people who have better chances of giving us bulk businesses. We go behind them, we give them free gifts, we give them free trials, and we make sure that they come and have food, and they, you know, think of us when the next opportunity comes. Second is, you can target customers who are staying nearby your area, your restaurant, your kitchen, your hotel, by displaying geo-local ads. You can literally pinpoint pin codes and show your ad to the people who are staying nearby. That increases your chances of getting orders, that increases your chances of increasing your sale and getting better revenue. Third is menu inserts. If you're comfortable with it and if it is really working, occasionally you can do physical menu inserts. And fourth is all the other activities which you possibly can, like Google marketing and display advertisements and everything that you can do, which comes under paid marketing. I hope this is understood by everybody. Type yes in the chat box. So this is the process how you do it. Now let me give you the action routine. What was LG full form? No, this is IG Instagram. Sachin. Instagram, Facebook, all the channels. Yeah. So now here is your action routine. What I mean by action routine is what you should focus on 80% of your time and what you should focus on 20% of your time. 80% of your time, you should focus on growing and nurturing your network connections. Whoever you have on Facebook, you have on WhatsApp, you have on, make sure that they don't forget you, and find ways, different ways in which you can send them information which will help them remember about your food and read that information and get more knowledge. You know, we always are attracted towards information which enriches our knowledge. Type yes in the chat box if you agree to this. If you are watching something and you really feel exciting, because that is really stimulating your intelligence. So you can, and on internet, you can find so much stuff which will really help your customers to increase their knowledge and at the same time think about you, because they will see who has shared it. Whenever we are watching some post on WhatsApp, whenever we are watching some post on Facebook or Instagram, we always look at who has shared it. Secondly, after you create this big network of different posts which are being shared all over the social media and which are being shared all, eventually you will start getting inquiries, and you should communicate with those prospects on those respective platforms. Third is fulfill the order. Fourth is, and this is one thing which people don't do, they don't take feedback. This is one of the biggest mistakes which people do. This is, feedback is one of the best ways to make sure to strengthen the bond with your customer, because nobody does it. You know, type yes in the chat box if you have, you know, had food at a beautiful restaurant and you go home and you don't even think of that restaurant for the coming 1 year. Why has that happened? Because nobody has cared about you when you went home. They just took care of you when you had a good food. They didn't take your feedback when you went home. So make sure that you don't do this mistake. You take feedback, you request them for a testimonial or a review, and you request them to share about your restaurant to their friends and families, which is easy for them to do on their mobile phone, frankly speaking. You can just send them one common post about your food business, if you wouldn't mind. Because once you have taken their feedback and once they have said thank you to you, you can ask for a request and they will not say no to you, because already they have thanked you for that. So once they have thanked you for that, sir, if you don't mind, could you please share about our restaurant? I will send you one simple image. We could share it on your Facebook, Instagram, as well as your WhatsApp. We will be very, very glad. They will happily do that because they have got a good feedback. So these are the four things which you should focus on continuously 80% of your time. Now, after this is one thing which a lot of people don't do. And this is where the real profits is hidden. Yeah. This step is called analyze and scale. Now, after you are in business for, let's say, 6 months, 8 months, you will have a certain idea of what is your best seller as far as your product is concerned and who is your best buyer as far as a person is concerned. Type yes in the chat box if you agree to this. Sir, what is the app you are using for this presentation? It is called MindNode, Shan. It is on Mac. It is called MindNode. MindNode. I think it cost around 3,000-4,000 rupees. It's a paid app. And you're most welcome. So once you identify your product and you identify your customer, it is your responsibility. If you want to really blow this business up, it is your responsibility to come up with same types of products or similar types of products to offer to your customer and to find the same type of customers to sell those products. Let me give you the same example which I gave you about college. So let's say, for example, you send a trial kit to a principal of a college and you got 200 orders. You can now reach 20 principals for 20 colleges near your area, and you can, ideally, you would be in a chance to get at least 500 or 1,000 orders in a month. Type yes in the chat box. So you have to identify the pattern. Who is the person who is going to have the most from you and what you can sell him the most, and find out the same type of people in the market in the nearby area so that you can go behind them and sell them to the most. So identify the patterns, repeat the process, and keep on testing new offers. You know, if you test 5 offers, one of them will be hit, 4 might go for flop. But that one item which is a hit will take care of your food business and it will take your whole business the long way. So you should keep on doing this. So this is analyzing and scaling is one thing which people don't do. They just stop their functions. I mean, most of the people are stuck in this whole activity. They are doing the marketing, they are communicating, they are fulfilling orders, they are taking, some people take feedback. In fact, a lot of people don't even take the feedback, but this is where their buck stops. But if you once analyze and if you scale and if you find the right type of people who are most likely to have food from you, let's say, for example, you have one principal in your hand who is ordering every month, let's say 200, 300 plates of whatever you are selling. You can take that reference of that person and you can reach some other principal, because ideally the requirements of that principal will be the same as the other principal. Type yes if you agree to this example. This is what I have done. You know, once we used to, when I was running Govindashram myself, you know, I first reached a company called Videsh Sanchar Limited, which is in Fort. I got an order of around 200, 300 people. I reached the other MTNL office. I reached the same company and I gave them reference of this company. Sir, we are selling food to this company. Why don't you order from us? Let us give you one free lunch. Let me take care of your lunch once. It is hardly going to cost me 1,000, 2,000 rupees. But I want to blow their minds away so that they are like, oh my God, this Gopal Kamath is good. Here, his Govindashram is great. And he's doing a great job. Let me give you an opportunity. The more you do favors on your customers or on your prospective customers, it will kind of like be a reciprocal effect. And the more it will come back to you in terms of orders, in terms of referrals, or in terms of recommendations or testimonial. So this is what I have in store for you for selling your food like hotcakes. Of course, I would have given you a lot of tactics and tips and how to design post and how to do this, which will come later. But this is kind of like the in principle thing which you need to focus in order to make sure that you are coming in front of your customers every time, whenever they are watching. So I call this as omnipresence. What do you mean by omnipresence is the moment. Let me stop the screen share. By the way, I will give you the link to the PDF, so don't worry. There is a concept called omnipresence. What is omnipresence is the moment a customer gets up in the morning and he watches WhatsApp or Facebook or Instagram, everywhere he watches, he should see some or the other post about you. It might be an inspirational post. It might be a post about your food. It might be a post about your offer. It might be a post about whatever you have shared. So wherever he moves his head, so you know, he watches on TV, on YouTube, your video will come up. He watches on the phone. He opens WhatsApp, your post will come up. He watches Facebook on his laptop, your post will come up. So if you are hammering that person, not in a salesy way, but in an indirect way, on the weekend or on the time when he really craves some food, whom do you think he's going to order from? He's going to order from you only because you have been in front of him. So this is kind of like the guerrilla tactic way of reaching your customers and making sure that you get as many orders as possible.
I hope you like this session. Isn't it true that getting mastery in promoting your food is far more important than making the food packaging it or buying it? You are in the marketing business, and the earlier you know it, the better. The earlier you start focusing on it and giving your 80% attention towards promoting your food, the more sales you will make, the more profits you will make. If you have liked this video, of course, subscribe to this, share this. Like this video, share it with your friends, families, wherever you want. And if you really want to go deep, want to work with me or want to know more about how we take a lot of existing food business owners or aspiring food business owners and help them to start a food business, join the link in the description section for my workshop and I will see you inside. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope to help you and to make sure that you really, really get a lot of profits in your food business. Thank you so much. This is Gopal Kamath signing off. Love from me. Bye-bye.